Hey, it's Pete Thorne. Welcome to my studio and welcome to my demo of the UA Aux Amp Top Box. So I'm a big UA fan, been using their interfaces for a long time as well as their plugins and stuff. So when I heard they were coming out with the Aux, I was really excited and it does not disappoint. You heard it on all the guitars on that track at the beginning of the video. Now, some of you out there still might be confused about exactly what this thing is, or you might have kind of an idea but not know about all the features. I'm going to try and show you most of it in this video. Number one, it's a reactive attenuator. That's one of the things that it does. Okay, so you can come out of a guitar head, tube head, into the aux, run into a guitar speaker cabinet, and you can use the aux to lower the volume of your guitar amp, pretty much any volume. So, you know, you got a 100-watt amp and you want to use it at a club and you're tired of club owners screaming at you about the volume, or even in an apartment, you can use it to lower the volume all the way down to TV volume if you want. So that's really cool. That's a great use for the thing, but it does so much more than that. So in attempting to explain what else it does, I'm going to read right off the copy off UA's website here. They say, the Aux Amp Top Box allows you to play and record your tube amp in its perfect tonal sweet spot anywhere and at any volume. So not only is it a reactive attenuator, it's also a reactive load box. That means you can load down your amplifier all the way down to line level. Your amp's going to be happy. It's still going to think it's plugged into a speaker cabinet and respond the right way. That's the reactive part. And you take that line level out, either digital or analog. You can run into your recording interface. Now you can record the sound of your amplifier. Okay, so the one thing missing, of course, would be speaker simulation. You're going to need to add some speaker sim to the sound. So this thing does that too. Aux also offers album quality mic and speaker cabinet emulations, UA's dynamic speaker modeling, onboard UAD effects, and much more. Okay, so this is going to allow you to add cabinet simulation, mic sim, as well as some really, really great sounding UAD effects to your tone. Take that line out, go into your recording interface, and you can now record your amp, you know, even at home through headphones or something like that, and get real world class, studio quality sounds. So you heard it on all the guitar parts at the beginning of the video, and everything that I was doing in those guitar parts was coming out of the aux. Okay, so all the effects, all of the reverbs and delays and all that good stuff, and certainly all the cabinet and microphone stuff, that was all the sound of the aux. And I used a whole bunch of different amplifiers. I mean, my PT100 on both the channel 1 and channel 2. I also used my Vox AC15 amp. I used my Fender Bassman head. I used that 71 Marshall back there, my Comet, all kinds of different stuff. So what I want to do in this video is solo a bunch of those different parts outside of the mix and detail some of the choices I made as far as microphones and cabinets and effects that I added to the amplifier sounds. So I'm going to break all that stuff down. But one of the other things I'm going to do is just give you kind of a very informal demo of the aux, just kind of setting up a tone and stepping through a bunch of the different cab and mic sounds available. Now, there's a beautiful integrated app that you can use in order to select all the different cabinets and effects and stuff like that. You can run the app on either an iPad, which is what I'm doing here, or on a Mac computer. You don't have to use the app to use the aux. You know, you can plug the aux in even without a computer or anything like that, say into a powered monitor or something, and there's six sounds that come up dialed in right from the factory on the front of the thing on a six position knob, and you're gonna be able to get everything from 412s to open back 212s and stuff like that without even using the app. So that's really cool. But when you use the app with either an iPad or your Mac, it opens up a whole world of possibilities of tweaking. It's deep, but it's also very elegant and simple and easy to use. So I want to do a part of this video where I just plug that RSA31 amp there into the aux, and then I'm going to step through a bunch of different cabinet models and microphone models and turn on and off effects and stuff like that, and try and give you a feel of what it's like working with the app, because the app is integrated so beautifully with the aux that they just kind of go hand in hand, and it's a big part of the whole thing. So that's my goal in this video anyways. All right, so let's get to it. I'm gonna break down a bunch of those different tones now, and then towards the end of the video, it's a very long video, by the way, it's almost 30 minutes long, but I'm trying to do a thorough job in this one, so feel free to skip around. Towards the end of the video is where you're gonna see me kind of, you know, creating a tone using the RSA31, stepping through all the different mic and cab models and trying some different stuff and just seeing what we end up with. Okay, let's get on with it. Here we go. curious, one of the things I wanted to do is just kind of very informally demonstrate the aux here, hooked up the iPad and just kind of mess with a tone, change some cabinets, change some microphone choices, play with some effects, that kind of thing, just really off the cuff and on the fly. So I've got my Sur guitar here hooked up to that divided by 13 RSA-31. I haven't used that amp in a long time. I hooked it up today. I'm like, why am I using this amp? It sounds great. So it's very much like an AC-30 style circuit. I'm coming 16 ohm out into the aux, which is sitting over there, and I got the aux hooked up via Wi-Fi, to this iPad that's right here. I should mention, the nice folks at Triad Orbit have sent me the stand for this iPad that I'm using right now. I've got the iPad clamped on my desk, and you can use these Triad Orbit stands to kind of move an iPad anywhere you want and very easily clamp it, and so it's working out great. Thanks, Triad Orbit. I really dig it. Yeah, what have I got going here? It's the 212 Ace Top cabinet, which is like an open back 212 with blues. Seems like an appropriate cabinet for this style amp. And here's the tone. Okay, sounds really cool to me. I've got a 57 set off axis, Royer style 121 model of microphone as well. And so those are my close mics, two close mics blended. And I've also got a stereo pair of condenser microphones for the rooms going right now. So if I wanted to, first of all, just change the speaker cabinet, it's really, really easy to do. I got a 212 going. With blues seems appropriate for that amp, but let's say we wanted to hear a 112 with an Alnico blue. Really like it, actually. I'll go back to the 212 and you can compare. It's a little bit different. The 112 is a little bit more forward and warm. I actually really like it, so I think I'm going to stick with that. Let's just try a couple others. Here's a 112 Greenback 25. Okay, a little bit more scooped and brighter sounding. Here's a 112 Black Deluxe. Okay, that's cool too, but I'm going to stick with that 112 with the blue. Okay, and that's how easy it is to change cabinets. I mean, it's just, you can just page through and pick the one that sounds best to you, and you're off and running. Sounds really good. Now, there's a switch here labeled 50 watt and 100 watt. If you're using amps 50 watts or below, you know, it's basically like a headroom switch, kind of. So if I switch to the 100 watt, it's going to drop the volume a little bit. Right, so it's basically just limiting the input coming in a little bit so that you've got more room for louder amplifiers. So if you're using an amp, say, over 50 watts or maybe 100 watts, something like that, use that 100 watt switch. If anything 50 watts and below, use the 50 watt switch. Let's experiment with the speaker drive control a little bit. So right now I've got it set at about 11 o'clock. If I turn it all the way down, volume's going to go up just a little bit, and it's going to sound like a brand new speaker, basically. We'll bring it up halfway. Sound gets a little sloppier, and the volume goes down a little bit. It's a little bit more relaxed sounding. A little bit more punchy, and, you know, like, sounds like a new speaker at the bottom of the control. So bringing it up halfway. That's maybe, you know, a little too broken in for me. I would try it about 11 o'clock, but I'm going to turn it up all the way for the extreme setting. Sound the most sort of dull, and, you know, as you, especially with some higher gain settings, you're going to notice as you move up the neck with that control turned up, you're going to get things like ghost notes and anomalies like that. So they've modeled all that stuff. So it's just another control that's great because you can really, you know, just dial in your tone. So I'm going to set it about 10:30. Okay, now as I said, I've got a blend here of three different microphones, a 57, a 121, and some condensers in stereo. I guess it's four different mics if you count the rooms as being stereo. Let's mute the stereo rooms and the 121. Let's just listen to this 57 for a second. volume's going to go down a little bit, just like it would in the real world, because we just got one mic going now instead of, you know, three other ones. Okay, so that sounds cool. I've got the off-axis switch on right now. I'm going to turn that off, and that means I'm going to be moving the microphone kind of right close to the center of the speaker, and it's going to get brighter. Okay, so that off-axis switch is just a real quick way to tame top end and allow you to warm things up a little bit, and kind of like you're moving the mic off from the center of the speaker, basically. And if you feel like there's too much low end in your sound, which I don't with this tone, but if I did, I can hit the low cut filter that's on every channel in the app. Okay, so if you got a real bassy amp, or, you know, if you're playing heavily distorted or that sort of thing, and you feel like there's too much bass, you can just hit that and it's going to roll off the lows. It's pretty cool. So if I would say wanted to change this microphone up to something different than a 57, let's listen, for example, to the 421 for a minute. I actually really like that. It's a little bit darker sounding, a little bit fuller through the mid. We'll see. I'm going to leave it there for a minute. Let's see how it blends once we put the 121 in, which is going to be my second close mic. It's dark as well, darker, so maybe it'd be too much of that thing. So I'm going to unmute the 121. Let's listen to it. I'll mute the 421. Here's the 121 ribbon mic. You can hear that bottom end coming in now. Maybe we should use the low roll-off on this mic. I think it helps to clean the sound up a little bit with this particular amp and using this microphone. Okay, so now let's blend that 121 with the 421 and hear the tone. That sounds really good to me. So, you know, going back to the 57 for a second, let's just check that out. The 121 is really cool. Is it too dark? I don't know. It would depend on the song, you know, and what everything else is doing in the track. But this is the beauty of this thing. You can just experiment so quickly, faster than you could in the real world. You have to run out in another live room, change the mics out, and all that business. You know, I think I'm going to go with the 57. I think it's got the attack that we need. Let's go over to the room mics now. Let's unmute the rooms. I'm going to solo the rooms. And this is a stereo pair of condenser room microphones. Okay, now this is something that you're going to have a really, really hard time getting unless you own a great studio. You know, to have a good room that you could place mics way back in and turn an amp up loud enough to get it cooking, how many of us have that? I actually do have that here. I have a pretty good room over there. But a lot of people don't have that. So it's like, and you know, if I want to go home and record, like I am actually going to go home, take a couple of amps and do a bunch of stuff for my record, just finish up my record at home. Here's the solution. Very simple. Those room microphones just lend so much character and realism to the guitar tones. You heard it in the song at the beginning of the video, especially on that 335 solo that I was doing. It was basically like a real dry solo, but had lots of the rooms mixed in and just lends a lot of character to the sound. So, this is stereo room microphones right now. Let's listen to maybe the mono condenser, condenser 67 in mono. So you can hear it's right up the middle now. If you're gonna maybe be recording a lot of guitar parts in a song and you know, you're gonna be panning them out, you might as well just use the mono room mics, really. I mean, it's gonna leave a little bit more space in the mix for everything. If it's just two or three guitars going on, you might wanna go with the stereo mics. Just depends. Let's check out the ribbon in mono. much darker, much more rolled off on the top end. So if you want that kind of character going on, go with the ribbon microphones. Here's the ribbon 121 microphones mono. This will have a little bit more top end than the 84, which is what I was just using. That's the RCA style 84. It's actually substantially darker than the 121. Let's go with that 121 and see what it sounds like blended now with, and maybe I'll just leave it in mono. Let's see what it sounds like blended with the close microphones. Pretty great guitar sound. I'll pull that room back a bit because it's a little loud. A little bit out of control. Even pulled back a bit. Watch when I mute it and just listen to what happens. You know, it just lends a really nice realism to the tone having the rooms mixed in. And that's the thing that you just can't get unless you got a decent studio. Now you can with this thing. So condensers in stereo. That sounds really good too. This is the thing that if you're home and you're playing through headphones with an amp or maybe through your studio monitors, you want to get like that room, amp in the room feel that everybody's always trying to get. You know, blending in some of the rooms and especially in stereo. Sounds really cool. Just lends a lot of realism to the tone having the rooms in there. Okay, so I've got a 57 and I've decided to set it off axis for a little bit darker tone. I got a 121 and I'm rolling off the low end a little bit, and then I got condensers, microphones in stereo. Oh, one more thing about the room mics. They've got this dampening feature here, and this is sort of the equivalent of hanging a bunch of soft stuff in a live room to deaden it, you know, maybe putting some carpets down or something. See if you can hear the difference. Just deadens it up and tightens it up a bit. You can really hear it, of course, when it's soloed, so let's do that. This changes the tone a little bit, so I'm going to leave them off because I like that live kind of sound. Boy, that sure sounds good. Really good sounding amplifier, and it sounds just great with the aux. Okay, so I'm happy with the EQ, so I'm not going to play with that too much, but you can see here I can pull up a graphic EQ, and if I decided there was something offending... Don't have it on yet. Switch it on. You know, real easy to hone in on a frequency that you want to cut or boost. There's also low and high cut filters here. You know, for real extreme shaping of both the top end and the low end. Maybe you want to get a real radio kind of guitar. I mean, not like in a good way. I mean, like a guitar that sounds like it's coming through an AM radio. You could go like this. You know, maybe just for the intro of a song, and then, you know, switch that out. Something like that. Anyway, so the EQ, really, really useful to have it just there and on tap at any moment. You may need it. Okay, let's listen to the 1176 compressor a little bit, what that can do to just even out our sound. It's not really the same as using a compressor in front of an amplifier, like a pedal style compressor. It's not as dramatic. You want to use these style of compressors sort of post-amplifier to kind of just level out your tone and even out the peaks and not do anything really dramatic. Like, you're not going to get like country chicken picking stuff out of it or something like that. But it does a cool thing. Check it out. Thank you. nice for evening out just about any kind of guitar tone. You know, it's going to take it and kind of make it a little bit more sort of friendly in the mix, just push everything forward. And you kind of want to use it subtly, in my opinion. Okay, let's add some delay to this sound now, because delay's fun. We all like delay. It sure sounds cool. I really like the delay trails with this delay. I've got it rolled back to about 4K on the top end because it's got high cut and low cut filters. And I've got it rolled up to about 240 hertz on the low end. And as the delay trails, it just kind of thins out a little bit, both in the top end and, you know, becomes more mid-range sort of centered. And I love that. This is called crossover delay, by the way, and so it's obviously doing, you know, a couple different taps and meeting in the middle and doing some really interesting stuff, so I really dig the delay. Let's check out the plate reverb for a second, turning it on. Boy, it sounds good. Sounds expensive. Really expensive. Plan. I'm just having fun. Sounds good. I'm going to turn on the delay, and I'm going to call up one of the presets that I used in the song at the beginning of the video, which was called Warm Clouds. I'm just going to dial that in right now. Thanks for watching my video on the Aux Amp Top Box from my good pals at UA. I hope in this video I was able to kind of convey what it's like working with this thing. Obviously it sounds great, but I wanted to try and give you an idea of what the workflow is like, because the app integrates so beautifully with the Aux itself. I don't know what the word is, but it's ergonomic. You know, it's just like a really, really fun workflow. It's easy to use and yet it's deep. There's a lot of options there, but it's fun. It's fun to use and make sounds and really easy to make new tones and store presets. And just the workflow is really, really cool. So UA has kind of hit it out of the park in that respect, I think. You can check it out further at the website you see there on your screen. And hey, please come back and see me for more videos real soon. I am Pete Thorne. Take care.